Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Wake Up Report. Didn't we just talk about this? I just did a show about this. I actually was not going to deal with this because, you know, I already covered a show about some idiotic, moronic black man that insulted a black woman because of her skin color. And here we are. Here we are again. Gilbert Arenas has to be one of the most ignorant individuals on this planet. And not because of the current ridiculous comment that he made, but his Twitter is just full of some of the most stupid comments that an individual could ever make, let alone making comments about your own women that are just outright hideous, disrespectful, and are a strong indicator of just how much you hate yourself as opposed to you hating on other people. And you know, what did this guy accomplish in the NBA? You know, aside from faking an injury so an equally talentless player could get more playing time, multiple injuries, which did result in you collecting a paycheck, big fat paycheck that you really didn't earn, so you really don't have anything else to do with your time except walk around and just be a source of quotable garbage from that pea-sized brain of yours. And I know that the NBA and I believe he went to Arizona State, they can't be responsible for the conduct of these morons once they get out of the league and once they get out of college. But it really says an awful lot about a college, a learning institution, that you let clowns like this float through college with no education, no common sense, just morons. They're absolute morons. They go straight from college into the NBA, into big money, and they come out, they end their lives as stupid as they started their lives, man. It's just, Gilbert Arenas is just one more example of my absolute loathing of the average black male athlete. They are a waste of time, they are a waste of energy, they are a waste of resources, and they are an absolute waste to black women. So unless you're of the light skin or you're a white woman. He tweets this horrific comment about Lupita being only, and you all seen it, you've seen the tweets, you've seen the responses of Lupita being attractive only when the lights are turned out. Easily, she's one of the most beautiful women on this planet. And once again, when your mind has been so beaten down with self-hate, when those self-hate chains have your brain so tied up that you're not even aware that you're making the stupidest of comments about your own people, basically about your mother, about her mother, about her mother, about every black woman that was responsible for getting you here. I want you to take a look at this picture, and you see Mr. Arenas and Lupita side by side. They are practically the same color. So when you say Lupita is only attractive with the lights turned out, you're really not talking about Lupita, sir. You're talking about yourself, because that is just like looking into a mirror. In fact, it is looking into a mirror. And that, unfortunately, is the state of mind for so many black people in regards to skin color. It's like we are going to be last on the boat when it comes to dealing with this issue. White people are moving past it. Other people are moving past it. We are the only ones who, by and large, are still caught up in this skin game, this light skin or light skinned versus dark skinned. This light skin are more attractive. Dark skin aren't attractive. Dark skin are this. Dark women are this. And dark, you know, it's just absolutely ridiculous. And when you have a black man like this, who, of course, you know, this comment went around the world because for whatever reason, the world is a platform for stupid black male athletes to say anything that they want. So this comment went around the world. Black women, that black man is letting you know what he thinks of you, what he thinks of his mother, what he thinks of his grandmother, what he thinks about every single black woman who is responsible for putting him in the position that he is in today. Oh, and I forgot to add your daughters, because you have two black daughters. who are eventually going to find these stupid comments, and it is a shame and a disgrace that they're going to find out that their own father has such disdain for black women that look just like them. So congratulations, Mr. Arenas, on infecting your daughters possibly in the future with more self-hate, more self-loathing, and possibly 1,000 hair weaves later, a couple of hundred cans of skin lightening cream later, that they'll find their place in the world because they know that black men that look like their fathers absolutely can't stand black women that look like them. Now, of course, Twitter and the internet jumped all over this clown, and he attempted to try to cover his behind by issuing a kind of sort of apology, if that's what it is. So I'm just going to read a little bit of it just to show you how stupid this moron is. I never say sorry for what I say, but it's my fault. I read this wrong and got into my feelings, which means you said exactly what you felt. I thought it was saying, and this is in reference to the message that he responded to, if you're mixed, you're not considered black and beautiful. And my kids are mixed and dark skinned, so I perceived it how I wanted to. Well, what you're saying is if you associated Lupita with only being attractive when the lights are turned out and you have two dark skinned daughters, what are you saying about your daughters? You said exactly how you felt. And the problem is when you got up and ran up into one of them light skinned girls that you salivate over and you're so thirsty for, but that black gene in you, that dominant gene, insisted that those girls come out dark skinned, you have no excuse for the stupid comment that you made about black women. You dark skinned black women. I might add, you said exactly how you felt about it. It's the same thing as somebody being drunk. When you're drunk, you tell the truth. There's a tendency to tell the truth. People will tell the truth when they're drunk or when they're extremely upset and the truth just comes out. They just lash out with the truth. And that's exactly what you did. So don't try to cover it up with some stupid, idiotic apology about you being a stupid, idiotic black man. So because I covered most of how I feel about this in my last show about the idiot that checked out on that beautiful dark-skinned sister. And if you haven't watched that show, I'd check that show out first, maybe before you finish with this one. I don't want to go there because I've already been there. So this is where we're going to go with this show. I'm going to let most of you black male athletes that run around with your light skin and your white women and your Latino women, and you're just as proud as you can be over the fact that you got you something light. And if you possibly impregnate that woman with your stupid gene, that you'll come out with light-skinned kids, and maybe they'll inherit the smart gene from their mamas, and they won't be as stupid as you are. But this is what's going on. 8 out of 10 of you with your light-skinned women, your light-skinned wives, your white girlfriends, or whatever it is, if you were not who you are, meaning NBA basketball players or athletes, if you didn't have the money that you had, if you didn't have the high-profile visibility that you had, the great majority of the women that you're so thirsty for would not look at you to spit on you. You see, a woman, especially a beautiful woman, can spot a thirsty sucker of a black male a mile away. For most of you, your exposure to white women comes through college, because living in the quote-unquote hood, all you dealt with were black women. But white women are no different than black women in the fact that when they see some money, when they see some opportunity, when they see that if I get my hooks into this clown and I can tolerate his ugly ass pumping up and down on me long enough where I can squeeze out a couple of kids, I can leave his dumb black ass. I will have walked away with half of his money and I can go on about my business. See, you're so caught up in white and light skin that you don't understand that most of that light and white skin that you value so much is absolutely disgusted by your appearance. There was an Esquire, it hurts me to this day that I did not save that article. This was an Esquire article. It was written back in the 90s, I think. They talked about basketball groupies. So I had this group of black women. They were all light skinned. And they talked about NBA players like dogs. They absolutely talked about it. They just called them all kind of hideous names like ugly, gorillas. The sex was good because they were so athletically in shape. So, you know, they got good sex out of it. But because of their light skin, because of their pretty white girl features and whatnot, they knew that the majority of those dark skin, ugly ass, and these are their words, not mine, dark skin, ugly black men were going to salivate and be so thirsty all over them that if they hung in there long enough, they're going to walk away with a payday. And most of you black dumb hick athletes, you fall for it like a ton of bricks. And if you notice, with the majority of these black NBA players, they get divorced, 5 to 8 years after they hook up with their light-skinned, high yellow queens and their white queens. Those women run them through the ringer financially no worse than any dark-skinned black woman ever would. So it has nothing to do with a person's skin color, and you are so stupid, especially stupid idiots like Gilbert Arenas, that you can't make the difference and the connection between your absolute hatred of yourself and how you would rather give your money away to somebody who hates you simply because they don't look like you, as opposed to giving your money away to somebody who looks like you. So for all my dark-skinned black women out there, you know, black men are slow learners. Broaden your horizons. You don't have to put up with this nonsense. As the world begins to open up and become more accepting, you know, you get them bigoted racist shackles off of you, and you can look at black women, dark-skinned black women, and you can see how beautiful they are because of what they look like. Don't limit yourself. Find that white guy that appreciates you because of what you look like. Find that Latino guy, that Asian guy, whomever it is. If they love you because you're dark and black and beautiful, then that's where your love is supposed to come from, as opposed to waiting for idiotic black men like this to come around and see the error in their stupid moronic ways. I'll tell you when Gilbert Arenas is gonna appreciate the dark-skinned black woman is when that high yellow priestess that you worship so much takes you for every nickel that you have, and you're wishing that that dark-skinned woman that you loathe so much, your mother, was still alive so you could go live with her. This is KTM and the Wake Up Report saying think a little bit. It will do wonders for you.